Hello guys, welcome back to Techdose, and in this video we will see the last stone weight problem, which is from Leetcode day 11 of the 30 days coding challenge. So let us look at the problem statement. The problem here says that we have a collection of stones and each stone has a positive integer weight. In each turn we choose the two heaviest stones and smash them together. Suppose the stones have weights x and y and x is less than equals to y, then the result of smashing two stones x and y with each other will be, if x is equals to y, then they both will be destroyed, and if x is not equals to y, then definitely x will be less than y according to this condition, and so y will be left with some weight and y will lose equal amount of weight, which is the weight of x. So let's say if weight of x was 3 and weight of y was, let's say, 4, then by smashing x with y, y will be left with weight 1 only, and this weight x will be destroyed. Now whenever you are left with a weight, you will add this to our list of stones. At the end, there is at most one stone left, there can be 0 or 1 stone left. So return the weight of the leftover stone, or you will return 0 if no stone is left. So let us look at an example in order to get a better understanding. So I have taken 4 stones. So this is our list of stone where there are 4 stones and these are the weights associated with those stones. So according to the problem, I will pick the two heaviest stones. So I will pick this 7 and I will pick this 4. So I will pick 7 and 4 and will smash them together. So when we smash them, they both will lose equal amount of weight unless one is destroyed. So this 4 is less than 7, so 4 will be destroyed, and so this will become 0. So this is completely destroyed and will be removed, and this 7 will now become 7 minus 4, which is 3. So since this weight is not 0, so it will again get inserted into this list. So this list will now become 2, 1, 3. Now we will take the two heaviest stones and will smash them together. So 3 and 2 will be taken out. 2 will be smashed against 3. In this case, 2 is the lighter one, so this will be completely destroyed and it will become 0. This 3 will become 1. So 1 will get inserted since this is not 0. And so our new weight list will be only 1, 1. Now we will pick the two heaviest stones, which is 1 and 1. So we picked them both, we smashed them together, and we find that they both will be destroyed because they are of equal weights. So they will be 0, 0, so they cannot be inserted back. So our list will now be empty. And since we have an empty list, so we will return 0 as our answer. If there was one stone left, let's say there was weight 2 here, then after smashing, weight 1 would have left and this would have been present in our array, and so this would have been returned as our answer, since this is the weight of our leftover stone. So I hope you got the problem statement. So what comes into your mind? Let's say if you have this array of stones, that is 4 stones, then you need it at least in sorted order because you need to pick the two heaviest stones. So in a simpler approach, you will just take the two heaviest stones and then you will just smash them and again insert it back, and you can use insertion sort or any other technique. But you can also sort this array, but sorting will not solve this problem because you can sort in just n log n time, but then after sorting, let's say you have sorted this array, so it will become 7 4 2 1, but after smashing these two stones 7 and 4, the output will be a stone which is left over and has weight 3. So this 3 can be present anywhere in our array. So these two will be removed, and so you can use insertion sort in order to find the correct location of this 3. So this is again taking a lot of time. So again and again you need to use insertion, and this might go to n square time. So how can we reduce it? How can we avoid sorting this array again and again? For this purpose, we will use a heap data structure. Let's say we have these 4 stones as our array of stones. So we will insert it into a heap. So we can make a heap using this array, and build heap takes order of n time. So let us make a max heap since we want to extract the two maximum weights each and every time. So after making a max heap, it will look something like this. I am not making the actual structure of a heap, but then I am just showing the arrangement. Like if you pick the first element, then this 10 will come out. The second largest is this one, and so on. But actual arrangement might be different, because it is a tree structure. I am not showing it in a tree structure, I am just showing it in a linear way so that you can understand it. Now I will pick the first element and the second element. So this is a max heap. So max heap will always have root as the maximum element of the tree. So this 10 we can take it out by popping, and so we will get the first element. We can take out this 7 as the second element, so this will be 7, and this is also taken out, this is also taken out. Now we can smash them together. When we smash them, then this will be left with the weight 3, and this will be completely smashed and its weight will be 0. Now we want to insert this weight 3, since it is not 0, into our heap. So we will use insert or push into a heap. So pushing an element takes order of log n time, because we need to heapify after pushing. So we can push it, and now the arrangement will become 4, 3, 2. So you don't need to worry about the arrangement. Heap will take care of the arrangement itself. Now you want to take out the two maximum weights, so you will take out 4 and 3. So 4 and 3 will be gone, and they will be smashed together. So after smashing, you will be left with this weight 1, and this will be 0 since this is the smaller weight. So this 1 will be pushed again into our heap, and our heap will now contain 2 and 1. So this will be the arrangement. Now we will take out the two heaviest weights, which is 2 and 1, and then we will again smash them together. So 2 and 1 are smashed together. This will be left with weight 1. This will be left with weight 0. So 1 will get inserted into this heap, and this will be left with this 1. So now we have only one element into the heap. So we will return the weight of whatever element is left. So the weight is 1. So our answer will be 1 here. I hope you understood the solution using heap. So let us analyze the time complexity for this. The push operation is taking order of log n time. Pop operation is taking order of log n time. Since after pushing we need to heapify, and after popping an element we need to heapify the heap. And this total number of operations we are performing is just n. Because in each smash, at least one stone is completely destroyed. So if you think about it carefully, then we have just n operations at most. In each operation, we are performing two pop operations for taking out the two heaviest weights, and then if any weight is left, then we will just push it into the heap. Then the total time will be 3 log n for each operation. Now at most we have n operations, so total time will be 3 n log n, and this will be amortized to n log n time. So this is the time complexity for this algorithm. So now let us look at the code in order to get a complete understanding. Now this is the code which I wrote by using priority queue. So priority queue is same as heap. I have taken a max heap. I kept the number of stones in n, and then I have inserted each and every stone one by one into this heap. So this insertion is actually taking n log n time. But then you can improve this time to just order of n by using build heap. Now I have taken a first and the second variable in order to take out the first maximum and the second maximum from the heap. So I will pop first maximum, I will then pop it from heap, take the second maximum, pop it from heap. Now I will decrement the number of stones by 2, since I have taken out 2 stones. Now if there is something left over, that is if the weights are not equal, then one stone will be left with something, and since first is greater than second, so first minus second should be greater than 0, and if some weight is left, then we will just push it into the heap and then increment the number of stones by 1. So when will we stop this process? We will stop when we are left with just 1 or 0 stones. So this is the condition. Now after doing these operations, we will check if the heap is empty. So if the heap is not empty, then we will return the weight of the leftover stone. Otherwise, if the heap is empty, then we will just return 0. So I hope you understood the code. This code will be present in the description below, so you can check it out. If you have any alternate solutions, then please post it in comments so that everyone can benefit from it. If you have any type of doubt, then feel free to comment below and I'll try to help you as soon as possible. Like and share our video and subscribe to our channel in order to watch more of this programming video. See you in our next video. Thank you.